Good evening and welcome to the CREC TV CRAL Championship between Two Rivers High School and Hartford Magnet Trinity of Hartford. My name is Al Collins.
My name is Mike Collins. Good to be here. Let's see what the big boys can do.
Mike, it's a pleasure. It's been an exciting couple weeks. I'm excited.
No, it's not. I'm glad Antonella Macron was able to fill in for me during the girls' game, but I missed it. I really wish I could have been here, and I heard it was a good game.
It was. Let's get ready for the starting lineups.
That's first for the Phoenix of HSTCA. At guard, number one, Roosevelt Orr. Also at guard, number 13, Javon Watson.
Von Watson.
At forward, number 15, Terrence Weaver Bay.
Forward, Terrence Weaver Bay, number 15.
Also at forward, number 35, Kaywan Miller.
Number 35, Kaywan Miller.
And at center, number 33, Hassan Podzik.
And at center, number 33, Hassan Watson.
Here come your Two Rivers Hurricanes.
For your home Two Rivers Hurricanes. At guard, number one, Kenny Jernigan.
At guard, number one, Kenny Jernigan.
Also at guard, number four, Fitzroy Webb.
Also at guard, number four, Fitzroy Webb.
At forward, number 20, Darren McGregor Jr.
At forward, number 20, one of the captains, Darren McGregor
also
Jr.
At forward, number 15, DJ Sutherland.
Also at forward, number 15, co-captain DJ Sutherland.
12, Amari Kelly.
And at center, number 12, Amari Kelly, also a co-captain.
To kindly stand and remove your caps for the national anthem sang by Two Rivers Destiny Rivera.
American Idol for a second. That was great.
Oh, yeah. She was wonderful. All right, Mike, here we go.
A lot of energy from both teams. I always like to see their pregame rituals, all the dancing around they do, and before they come out, it's great.
And here we go with those fancy sneakers again.
Of course. I expected nothing less. Well, hold on a second. I see a lot of the HMTCA kids, they're matching.
Yes, they are.
I haven't seen that all year.
All right, the Phoenix are taking the court.
Okay, what I noticed from last year and during the pregame warmups, number one on HMTCA, keep an eye on him, because you're probably going to lose him on the video feed. He's that quick. That's Roosevelt Orb.
And he had a year to train.
Absolutely. I mean, I was watching him during pregames, and he looked really sharp.
All right, here we go. All right, the Phoenix takes off with the ball. Again, welcome to CREC TV. 7:55 on the clock.
That's a three-point championship. Nothing but nothing. All right, recovered by Two Rivers. Here they come. Ooh, good cut.
Two Rivers is on the board already with two.
That's number one, Kenny Jernigan. Okay, Two Rivers in white is considered the home team, although we are playing on HMTCA's floor. Oh. A little scuffle under the rim there.
There's the whistle.
It's a timeout taken. It's an early timeout. I wonder what they want to talk about.
Already with 7:25 left in the clock.
That's kind of an unusual call.
Yeah, maybe they saw something that I didn't, but who knows?
They want to talk it over.
I mean, they're both in the championship, so these coaches, sir, do know what they're doing.
Yes, they do.
That little cheerleading action going on in this game.
We're not used to that.
No, I'm not.
All right, 7:25 left on the clock. Two Rivers, two. Hartford Magnet, Trinity, zero.
Ball will be inbounded by Kewan Miller.
All right, Phoenix is at the line.
Looks like number 33, Azeem Henzak. Henzik.
Sinks the first one. 1-2.
Behold the power of matching socks and shoes. Okay. All right, ball's recovered by HMTCA. The putback is no good. I see a lot of height underneath the rim for HMTCA.
Most definitely. Oh, nice.
There's
pass.
Roosevelt. Keep an eye on him. Quick three-point attempt. And look at that. He got his own rebound. That's how quick he is.
He got there pretty quick.
Yeah, and you know what? Not enough players do that enough, getting their own rebounds. Oh, there you go.
There you go. 4-1, excuse me, Two Rivers.
Okay, that was, again, number one, Jernigan. I think it's going to be a battle of the quicks here between the two number ones on both teams. Oh, yeah, wide open. Get in there. Yep, there you go.
There he is. Sinks it.
That's Henzik.
3-4 with 6:35 left on the clock. Again, you are watching CREC TV.
Looks like it's going to be a three-point attempt. No good. Okay, again, a lot of height down there for HMTCA.
There is. There's no help down there, though.
Oh, right
oh,
up.
He finished
right
it.
Up over.
That was pretty. 4-5. HMTC takes the lead. 6:13 on the clock.
That was right in the face of Captain Ari Kelly. He must not be happy about that. There's Kelly with the ball. Here's another. Nope. That's Fitzroy Webb with the shot. Oh, just misses. Okay, HMTCA slowing things down a little bit. Oh,
building
deep three-point shot.
And he sinks it. Oh, my goodness. HMTCA is on fire. Score 4-8. 5:36 on the clock.
That was Jevin Watson with an NBA big boy three-point shot.
That was big.
That shot
there
was
they
blocked.
Go again. There they go. He's got to slow it down, Mike.
Watch those ball handles. Look at that pass.
Oh, that was nice.
That was a great look. He just couldn't handle it. All right, let's see if Two Rivers can capitalize on the turnover.
You got to answer back.
Yeah, you got to take advantage of those turnovers for sure. Oh, it'll stay the same way. Good defense by HMTCA.
Staying there. I tell you, Mike, in the last couple years, I'm seeing a lot of improvement in the ball play and the skills, the talent. It's just becoming awesome.
Absolutely, and that's all you really would want. Oh, ooh, nope, didn't get it. So, what are we in our third year in our athletic program? And if you see that kind of improvement in your players, I mean, it's got to make you happy.
Oh, yeah.
Let's see what play they run here. Oh, right down the middle. That's number 12. Just
couldn't
misses.
Finish it. He just couldn't finish
it's
it.
Captain Amari Kelly just missing the backboard on that one.
Okay, here they come.
Oh, yeah, lightning fast.
That was coast to coast.
I blinked and missed it. That was number 13, Javon Watson, making up for that missed pass.
4-10, HMTCA with 4:39 left on the clock in the first quarter.
Number one on HMTCA, Roosevelt Orb. Watch him. He's making my eyes hurt. He's moving so fast. Oh, big block. Oh, no, I think they called it a foul.
You're watching the defense with the Phoenix. They're right there. They're building on it. Mm-hmm. Looks like they've been watching these kids play from Two Rivers for a while.
Yeah. If you know your opponents, you have an edge.
Yeah, Darren McGregor, team captain at the line for two.
We got number 23, Wilfredo Serpa, coming in for the HMTCA Phoenix. Misses them both. Here comes Orb. Oh, they're setting screens up in the half court. That's good. That's another big three-point shot.
Here comes Two Rivers. Hurricanes are trying to rebuild.
What a move!
I almost couldn't finish it.
Oh. All right, they get the foul.
That's all right.
They get the foul. But
that was awesome.
Al, I almost fell out of my chair.
Oh, my goodness. That was some fancy footwork.
I think I saw a near broken ankle there.
And at the line, we have Amir Kelly, number 12.
That was
going up for two.
Number one, Kenny Jernigan with that filthy move.
Sinks the first one. 5-10, 4 minutes even on the clock.
Oh, here we go.
Here comes
right
the
out.
Phoenix.
Look how quick he is. He stops. Right back up. Nope. There you go. Amari Kelly with the rebound. Here comes
Webb. The Hurricanes.
Right at him. Just can't connect. Oh, but there's,
they finish it.
There's Captain Kelly.
7-10, 3:38 on the clock.
That's how you got to do it. Crash those boards. That's what you got to do.
Wow.
Okay, here comes Jernigan. Passes it off to Webb. And that looks like a timeout on Two Rivers.
Wow, Mike, this is a great game.
Well, what do you think so far?
Oh, first I was a little optimistic, but now I don't know. Looks like it's going to be a good game. It's not going to be a blowout I thought it was going to be when I first got here today.
It seems like both teams certainly have the ability to penetrate, but there's a height advantage on HMTCA. I think that's pretty obvious, but it seems like Two Rivers is working harder for the rebounds.
It's,
and if that's
are.
The case, you just keep attacking the rim and let your big men come in for the putbacks.
Exactly.
Especially with, what's his name? Number one, Kenny Jernigan. I mean, he's been lights out all night so far.
All night long.
Got 3:21 left in the first quarter. It's 10-7 HMTCA.
Here we go. There's the Hurricanes.
Oh, that's a three-point shot.
Oh,
it's good.
He sets the three. Wow, Mike.
I think Jernigan's playing for an NBA contract.
It's a game. 10-10, 3:03 on the clock.
Oh, good dump off.
Oh,
nice
the
job.
Hurricanes are up by
little
two.
Little golf clap for Hanzik on the way back. Nice job. Oh, here comes Jernigan. He got him right when he started to attack the rim there. Oh, he's quick.
Oh, yeah, most definitely.
Okay, Darren McGregor, co-captain. He'll inbound the ball straight up to Kelly. Right back to McGregor. Oh. Oh, just can't do it. Oh, that's a volleyball spike. You got to go up with two hands.
And go up with two.
That's a travel. Ooh, they called it a jump ball.
2:31 on the clock, 10-12. Hartford Magnet Trinity up by two.
All right, McGregor with the inbound. A lot of movement. It's coming the other way. They tried to go inside. They did have Webb on the three-point line, but they decided to go inside on that one. That's Watson. Right over to Serpa, and that is good.
Oh, my God. Did you see that?
Yep.
15-10, 2:14 left on the clock.
They're professional-looking shots. What a move.
I saw a little walk there. I don't know about you.
Possibly. Oh, man. Both teams just, they're playing really hard.
They are playing. It's up again.
I think the refs missed that one. I think he was standing outside the arc.
17-10, Hartford Magnet Trinity.
If you're Two Rivers.
151 on the clock.
You gotta start figuring this out now. You don't want to be in an early hole. Oh, I thought that was in.
He tried to answer
There's
back.
There's Kelly with the rebound. Oh, Webb showing off his ball handling skills. Oh, Webb had a cut there. So he didn't see it. When Webb dumped it off over to Kelly, he could have cut to the basket, but just didn't see it.
Just didn't see it. You know what, Mike, I think if I was the coach of Two Rivers right now, I think I'd probably be calling the timeout.
Yeah, I mean, he's talking to his two main guys over here, Webb and Jernigan, who have been doing a spectacular job so far, but it's got to be a whole team thing, and they got to figure out what's going wrong.
Exactly. Two Rivers at the line for two. 17-10, led by the Phoenix of Hartford Magnet Trinity.
Oh, good put back. That's number 15, DJ Sutherland, co-captain. Hey, if you got to clean up on the boards, you better start doing that. That's
right.
What you got to do. There's Hanjin saying, let me in there. Okay, Webb's going to bring it up. And he's cutting right to the hoop, not messing around. Look at that.
Wow.
You know what, Al?
What's that?
Just take the risk and penetrate to the hoop. That's it. It's working. Keep it up.
They got a lot of heart
out
there.
Oh, look at this. Oh, wow.
There he goes.
Good fake.
Oh!
There's Hanjin.
They're finishing everything. Everything they take on, they seem to be finishing it.
When the shot goes up down there, you better get that big guy out of there. You got to box him out. I just think that teams that work harder for rebounds usually pull it off in the end.
Nice pass.
Good fake by Webb.
This couldn't finish.
Yeah, there you go.
There it is.
See? You know what?
There it is.
It's working.
It's working. 16-19, 23 seconds left on the clock in the first quarter.
Kelly doing a nice job down there. Mop up crew on the boards. It's a point guard show today.
Oh, my God. With 8 seconds left on the clock. 21-16.
Wow. You hold for one shot here. You got 4 seconds. Right to the hoop. Look at that. He drew the foul.
Wow. What an exciting first quarter. 16-21 led by Hartford Magnet Trinity.
And he's going to shoot. He's going to shoot too, I think. I think they called a foul on that.
Called a foul on it.
Yep.
Wow.
So everyone's going to come off the court because there's no point in having anybody there. But, you know, I would expect him to shoot. But he is completely fearless going to that hoop.
Most definitely.
I'll tell you right now, he's got the goods. So.
17-21.
Nails them both.
Sinked them both.
What a first quarter.
18-21 going into the second.
Both teams talking over strategy for the second quarter. I think they both know a lot more about each other at this point. But if I were either one of these teams, you got to have an answer for their point guards.
All right, here we go. 8 minutes on the clock. We're going to wrap up this first half. 18-21. Phoenix are going to take the ball out.
I got to tell you, I've enjoyed watching this game so far.
All right, Will Fredo's going to take it out for the Phoenix. Nice pass. Here we go. They're building it up. Set up.
Here comes Orb. Oh,
here it comes.
Oh, look at that look.
Look at that pass.
To make that pass going that fast, it's like an instinct that I'll never be able to understand because I'm a big man.
He's at the line for two.
I'd like to see Orb and Jernigan play one-on-one after the game.
That's right.
I'd pay money to see that.
We got Azeem. How do you pronounce that last name? I'm not
Looks
even
like
going to attempt that.
Hanzik.
All right. They're going to get mad at anybody. It's going to be you.
I apologize in advance. All right, misses them both. There's Kelly with the rebound, and here comes Jernigan. Oh, right to me. Almost had a souvenir. And I saved my soda.
Saved it, not a drop.
Looks like Wilfredo Serpa will inbound the ball.
Looking for a setup, setting it up.
The Zebras see something. I'm not sure what it is, but they're weighed up. Looks like there's maybe some water on the floor.
Cheerleaders are having a good time.
Yeah, you know, I think it's important to have cheerleaders at a basketball game. It kind of like adds to the atmosphere. Probably distracts both teams too.
I must have a lot of water on the court.
Probably melting all that snow at top because of how hot these two teams are playing. All right, Serpa's going to inbound. That is Watson bringing it up.
7:40 on the clock.
All right. They're doing a really good job pick and roll.
Did
look
you
at that.
See that?
Oh, big just man's got to finish.
It.
Big gotta man's got to finish. There's Jernigan. It's DJ Sutherland over to Webb. Back to Jernigan. Look at that defense by Orb. He's just harassing him. Oh, look, he's got that good baseline cut.
Oh, my.
Oh, took it right out of his hand. Good defense. Good defense. That's Serpa, number 23. Good pass.
That was beautiful. Yep. 7:06 on the clock, 18:23.
That's Terrence Weaver Bay with the nice cut. And, hey, the nice look by Orb. Okay, Sutherland looking around. Cross court. You never want to do that.
There he goes again.
Cross court
there
passes don't work. Oh, just missed.
They just couldn't finish it.
Okay, Webb's going to bring it up. They have an advantage here. He's going right at the hoop, little floater. And again,
and
cleaned
it.
Up by number 12, Captain Kelly.
6:36 on the clock, 20-23, still led by the Phoenix.
Again, another good look, and he can finish that time.
Phoenix answers back every time. 20-25, 6:20 left on the clock in the first half.
Great passing by both teams so far. Orb seems to have a lot of responsibility in this zone defense. I've seen him on a few different people at once.
Oh, yeah.
But he can take it. Look at him. He's everywhere. Oh, good pass. All right, Kelly can't handle it. Hanjin takes it away. Here comes Orb. Okay, Webb is denying. Hanjin,
did you see that pass?
Gosh, that was such a great pass. Oh. He wasn't looking at the ball. Oh. All right, stay in the same way.
Answer right back.
The big block. Okay, we got some subs coming in. Going to give Webb a rest and going to give DJ Sutherland a rest. So into the game, we have number 25 for the Hurricanes. That's Nashawn Williamson. And there's a shot by Jernigan. Oh,
Jernigan.
He's just on
he
fire.
He finishes it. 23-25 with 5:33 left on the clock. In the first
that was a three-point bucket. Okay, Williamson will guard Orb. Oh, just can't connect on
can't
that
finish
one.
It.
Looks like number 11 is in the game for the Hurricanes, Sean Dixon. It's a rebound.
Here comes the Hurricanes. They're going to try to tie this up.
Oh, good. He might have walked.
He walked it.
Sometimes those fakes are just too good.
Yep.
Well, giving him a hard time in the backcourt. I don't blame him. It's a really close game, 25-23 HMTCA.
Again, you are watching CREC TV.
Well, it looks like Orb's calling something. Here's that screen. Looks back. That's number 16. Number 15, I'm sorry. Oop. All right, it's coming back the other way.
Hurricane still trying to tie this up.
Oh, he is just unbelievable. That's good rebound by Captain Kelly. Taken away by HMTCA. He's quick. He's lightning fast. Oh, just didn't have the height on that one. But
Hurricanes are going to get another shot at it.
Yep. Showing a lot of heart going in there like that. Okay, 35, Kwan Miller is going to come back into the game. Along with number 22, that's Kervin Vincent for HMTCA.
4:14 left on the clock.
Oh. He's going to take a big boy NBA three-pointer. No good. Another rebound for Captain Kelly. He must have 10 by now. Okay, ooh, good look. A little bit too much body. Okay, it's important to note that HMTCA is in bonus right now. Okay, that's 7 fouls on 2 Rivers. So next foul, they'll go to the line for 1-1.
Yeah, they can tie this up.
There you go.
3:58 left on the clock. 24-25. He's got one more to go.
I'd say the fouling has been okay. I mean, if you're at 3:58 in the game or in the half with 7 fouls, it's a little excessive, but
exactly.
Not too bad. Okay, he hits the first one, so it's a 1-point game. Oh, right to the hoop. Not even contested.
That was easy.
Yep, that was number 13, Javon Watson. Easy layup.
27-24 at 3:42 left on the clock.
Both teams doing a good job attacking that baseline. Okay, here comes Webb over to Jernigan. Oh, God, he's just so fast. There you go. More cleanup, but a big block. I believe that block was number 22, Kervin Vincent.
Still going back to the Hurricanes.
Oh, just can't find it on that one. And that's going to be a foul. That'll do. That's 3 fouls for 2 Rivers. So they're definitely handling the foul situation a little bit better than HMTCA.
Yeah.
No foul trouble yet. I think Jernigan is wearing Spider-Man socks. And you know what? That's fitting. He's pretty much just as fast as him.
That's right.
Oh, look at that. Give and go. Give and go. Just can't connect. Oh, look at that spin by Orb. Oh.
Just couldn't finish it, though.
He's going to make me break my chair. I'm going to fall out of this thing. It's either going to be him or Jernigan, the way that they've been playing.
3:02 left in the half, 24-27.
Hey, that's another foul, so it's a 1-1 again. It'll bring Darren McGregor, a co-captain for the Hurricanes, up to the line.
You're in the bonus now. Is it a bonus free throws?
Yep, they get 1-1. And this is, you know, you can't put enough of a value on your free throws. If you can hit your free throws,
yep,
you're at a severe advantage here. So if he hits the next one, it's only a 1-point game.
That's right. 25-27 with 3:02 left on the clock.
Okay, here comes co-captain DJ Sutherland coming in, giving Victor Rodriguez a rest. There you go. Darren McGregor.
26-27. It's a 1-point game.
Okay, that's Weaver Bay. That's a Watson. Okay, that is Weaver Bay again. No good.
Here comes
Jernigan. Oh, he's going to take it right in there. But he says unselfish
nice
and a really good look.
Trying to slow it down just a little bit. This pass.
Jernigan with the 3-point shot.
Couldn't finish it.
Oh, yep, big rebound. And a big shot.
And they got it.
Hey, guess who's in the lead
out? That's right. The Hurricanes are up by one, 28-27, 2:28 on the clock.
Hey, came down from seven. They were down seven at one point. That's a timeout by HMTCA. And you know what? That's a good timeout. You're going into halftime. You just lost the lead.
Want to slow it down just a little bit.
Yep. Figure it out.
That momentum.
Big credit to the Hurricanes. They were down 7 points at one point, and they came all the way back, and they're up by one. All the games I've seen, the middle school, the boys game, the high school girls game, they've all been great games. This first half has been the most exciting first half I've seen yet. Just the showcase of ability.
You know, I didn't commentate, but I watched the CREC first girls play state playoff game the other night. That was an exciting game. Just to see the talent of these schools was awesome.
Yep, it's fun to watch. All right, Orb looking to set something up. It's probably going to be a screen up top. Hanjin's been doing a nice job of it, but they're moving around up in the foul line here. Here we go. It looks like a perimeter play. Nope. Over to Hanjin. Quick shot.
Couldn't
just can't find
it.
Oh, they're coming so close. Hey, here comes Spider-Man
on
over
the
web. Another good look. Oh, what a tip in.
Oh, that was nice.
That's Darren McGregor, co-captain, with the tip-in. Again, 30, a professional play.
Yes, 30-27 with 1:44 on the clock. And the Phoenix Suns is back for two.
That's
30-29.
That's a three-point shot, no good. But again, a nice
and
follow-up.
And two Rivers answers back. 32-29 with 1:29 left on the clock.
Hey, that shoot and let your big men get the ball strategy, it's working. Oh, got a little too close on that one. It's going to be a foul on Jernigan. Kawan Miller will inbound the ball. Let's see what they set up here. Right over to Hanson. Back to Kawan. Oh, good defense by Two Rivers. Look at that pass. Oh, you got to hope he's okay here.
Hope everyone's
he's all right.
Okay.
He's all right. Right. I wish I had a broadcast booth in front of me so I can do a highlight reel of the pass I just saw. That was incredible. It's really just been really fun to watch these guys play.
Yeah. A lot of talent out there tonight.
I'm going to ask for his autograph after the game. Don't judge me.
1:11 left on the clock. Hurricanes at the line for two.
Webb hits the first one.
33-29.
HMTCA one foul away from double bonus, which means two shots automatically. I mean, there's only a minute left, but a lot happens in basketball in a minute.
A lot happens.
Nails the second shot.
34-29, 1:11 on the clock. The Hurricanes are in the lead.
Here comes Orb. Oh, unselfish play. I don't know what that jump was all about.
I don't
kind
know.
Of, I think he was a little scared going up.
Here comes the Hurricanes.
Take Jernigan back to Webb. Little jump shot. Gets his own rebound. It's coming back the other way. All right, that's Kawan Miller with the rebound for HMTCA. Here comes Orb again, fearless, but just didn't have the height for that one again. Oh, open
pass.
Look. DJ Sutherland can't connect. But Webb
says,
I got it. I got you, big man.
36-29 with 26 seconds left on the clock. This game is awesome.
Yeah, to say the least. The little floater by Orb just can't connect on that one. If I'm Two Rivers, I'm holding for one shot.
Right there.
You have the lead. Why not give him a little dagger here?
There you go.
5 seconds on the clock. Jernigan, that's why I would want to have the ball. Here comes DJ Sutherland. No good. That's going to do it.
Wow, at the half, 36-29. The Hurricanes of Two Rivers. Mike, what an exciting first half.
You know, if you guys are watching this game on YouTube when it gets posted, you are really watching a quality basketball game. I'm having a lot of fun.
Oh, yeah, this is awesome. I mean, this is, like, great. I gotta tell you, this is better than last year's
game. Yep.
This gets better every year.
I mean, I'm getting into it. I'm a fan first and a commentator second, and this has been a fan's game. This is Mike Collins, and I'm joined by Mr. McCain. He is the principal of Two Rivers and the president of our fine athletic league. Mr. McCain, I know you just got here, but tell me about the girls' game that happened earlier.
The girls' game was a great game. It was our first playoff game for the states for our school, and we came out a little bit slow, but in the fourth quarter we took the lead, went battled back and forth. We ended up losing by four. A very exciting game.
Well, I'm sorry to hear that you guys were on the losing end, but I'm sure they had a really great season.
They really did. And the boys' game tonight that I've seen is fast-paced, energetic, great crowd here tonight. Our league is really moving forward. Very excited about it.
I mean, I know you just got here, but you're in for a really exciting second half of basketball. I almost fell out of my seat about three times watching these kids play. As the principal, your point guard, Kenny Jernigan, what are your thoughts on him?
Kenny is a great player. He's unselfish. He's quick. He gets the other team, gets our team excited to play. He's just a great kid all around.
They're all doing a great job, but he's been the most fun to watch, I think, so far. Him, Webb has been shooting the ball really well, and I keep calling him Captain Kelly underneath. They're doing a really good job, and they have the lead. They're up by 7 points.
Pretty excited because we're still a startup school. We don't have a senior class yet, so these kids will all be coming back next year. And Kenny and a bunch of our freshmen are out there playing. We're pretty excited for our future, too.
All right, well, I hope your team has really good luck in the second half, and it was nice talking to you.
Thank you so much.
All right, we're here with Adam Leonard, Athletic Director of Hartford Magnet Trinity. Adam, your thoughts?
It's a nice game.
It's an excellent game. It's what I expected between the first seed and the second seed in the league. Both teams are quick. Both teams are young. I know Two Rivers doesn't carry any seniors, and our team only has one or two seniors on the floor. So it's a game. It's two teams that are going to be battling for years to come. Quick up and down the floor, exciting. Looking for the same thing in the second half.
Adam, you know, this is like your third year in the league.
Correct.
Where do you see this going? It's like you guys are having a great couple seasons.
We're looking for the league to grow. Right now, with our varsity teams, we had three teams, I believe, on the boys' side and three teams on the girls' side qualify for the state tournament, which is excellent. We had some soccer programs in the fall qualify for the state tournament. So as a new league, first-year varsity programs, it's looking to grow. The key is going to be having the middle schoolers stay in every respective school to build those athletic programs, because the suburbs, they're starting them young, you know, and we need to catch up to that. It'll be a few years for us to catch up there, but I eventually see us competing with all of the schools around.
Adam, thanks a lot. Good luck.
You're welcome. Thank you.
All right, Mike, here we go, second half.
I can't wait. I don't want this game to end. All right, co-captain Darren McGregor will take it out for the leading Two Rivers Hurricanes.
All right, let's see how this
quick
one
pass.
Goes.
Oh, look at this. They're like, hey, you guys are having a conversation. We're just going to start the game. And it pays off.
It pays off.
Captain Kelly with the putback.
38-29, 7:48 in the third.
Big heads-up play by the Hurricanes, taking advantage of that situation that they were just in. Nice little give and go. Oh, really nice pass underneath.
They answered back.
Hey, that was
31-38, 7:31
Kervin Vincent
on the
with
clock.
The bucket.
Nice pass. And the Hurricanes, they finish up 40-31.
It's going to be a slugfest to end this game.
Going back and forth, man.
Here's Orb. Oh, he can stop on a dime. And look at that pass. It's unbelievable. Calling for the ball down low. And just, ooh, can't get it. Here
it
comes.
Almost lost it.
Little short, and there's your big men down low. I don't see Hansen in the game, and I bet you they're going to put him in there pretty quickly because of all the out-rebounding that's going on.
Definitely.
You want that height underneath. You got to have an answer for people like McGregor and Captain Kelly down low. All right, moving it up the ladder. It looks like TCA is trying to press. And that shot is no good. We'll try it again.
Saved
what
it.
A hustle.
Oh, and it paid off.
Great. The three captains putting on a show.
42-31, 6:36 left on the clock in the third.
We got Captain Kelly. We got Jernigan wearing Spider-Man socks. I'm just going to call this team the Avengers. What a block. McGregor with that block there. Huge block. Orb.
Oh, they just threw that one away.
Dishes it off to nobody. Here comes Sutherland's big bucket.
Oh, and he finishes. That was a big one.
Yep. They're pulling away
31.
Here. I don't know what the ref's calling here. Might be a delay of game. Looks like he said something underneath. You know, you're having a great game. There's no need to say anything. Just let your play kind of speak for itself here.
Right.
So if I'm the coach of Two Rivers, I'm letting my players know, hey, you're playing a great game.
That's
you know,
right.
Just let it speak for itself, and you'll be fine.
Let it be, yep.
You don't want technical fouls. Okay, they send Terrence Weaver-Bay to the line. So, again, fans, technical foul means you shoot two and get the ball back. You don't want that in a championship game. Don't give them opportunities like that.
Nope.
Hey, Two Rivers still has an 11-point lead, 6:05 left in the third quarter.
44-33.
Oh, he got him in the air. That's all he wants when you fake like that.
Oh,
big takeaway, and here comes Jernigan. Good look. There's Webb for the finish.
Yeah,
it's unbelievable.
That was fantastic.
It is
footwork.
So fun to watch these kids play.
Oh, my God. 46-33.
Okay. Here comes Orb. Let's see what they set up. Referee's taking a timeout. Let's see what the Zebras have to say here. Oh, there's something on the court. Good call. Don't want anybody tripping. Referees have some shiny shoes.
Had another sneakers.
I'm going to ask him to see if he can moonwalk. Some smooth criminal. Hands in back in the game. I told you they bring him back in. Here comes Orb. Let's see who this is on. I believe it's on the Hurricanes. That's on Jernigan. I'm not sure how many fouls that is on him, but he is the last person you want out of this game.
Definitely.
Okay.
You see that?
Yep.
I haven't seen that since the 70s.
That's a big man move. And good defense by Amari, Captain Kelly over there. You don't want to get in foul trouble.
I think I just told my age.
Hansen was calling for the ball. He finds him, just can't handle it.
46-35, led by the Hurricanes with 5:15 left on the clock. I think I was thinking about Kareem Abdul-Jabbar.
No, little skyhook. Oh,
ooh.
They run into each other. It's almost like Orb's passes are too quick. Good look to big man down low. Another good look. That was great ball movement.
The Hurricanes
again,
are trying,
just can't finish.
Trying to clean up a little bit.
Yep. All right, Jernigan takes it right in, but Hansen had a really good stance there. Didn't jump, just put his hands up, and that's really all it took. Okay. There's Jernigan for three. Oh, boy.
And he finishes
with ice in his veins.
49-35.
No regard for human life. All right, Hanzik. I can't see because of all the players. That's okay, though. It's a good shot. Just can't get in there. All right, here comes Jernigan. Good look. Sutherland goes right up with it.
51-35 with 4:21. What is going on with the Phoenix?
I have no idea. But Two Rivers is really starting to run away with this game. That's a 16-point lead. You wouldn't know it, by the way, that the Two Rivers coach is reacting.
That's right. Coach Jeff Kramer, he's really into this.
Well, I mean, he's right to be upset. You don't want to get into foul trouble.
No,
I mean, it's only
don't.
Three fouls, but still. Okay, that's Javon Watson at the line. score is still 51-35.
I made a mistake. That was Blaise Brassier as the head coach of the Hurricanes. I'm sorry.
Okay, Jernigan's going to get a rest, and in comes Webb.
Jeff Kramer is the coach of the Phoenix.
Okay, Watson will hit the second three-pointer. Three-pointer, I'm sorry. Foul shot.
51-36, still ahead by the Hurricanes.
Ooh, he might have gotten away with that one. Oh, big move.
Ooh.
Captain McGregor forces another timeout for HMTCA. You really have to regroup right now. You're down 17 points. This is the championship game.
That's right.
What do you think HMTCA has to do to get back into this game?
Yeah, then you really need to slow it down. Looks like they lost their, you know, their I just can't put my hands on it. Yep. I don't know what happened because the first quarter, it was like a total different team.
Yeah, they didn't come out with a lot of steam, it seems like. They seem a little defeated right now. They really got to pick up the intensity. My team, Dragons, you know, coaching the MLC Dragons, it seemed like all year they would get down, and then in the second half they would have that sense of urgency, and they'd turn it on.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Let's see if HMTCA can do that here.
Gotta, they need that sense of urgency right now.
Yeah. I mean, there's no other place for it.
I'm seeing a different team from what we saw on this court 12 months ago.
I'm seeing a different team from the first half. First half, it was a slugfest, and right now they're getting dominated on both ends of the court.
That's right. Four left in the third quarter, 53-36.
All right, let's see what HMTCA can do here. Right to big man Hanzik, takes it right in.
Oh, what a block.
Captain Kelly rising.
All by himself. Oh.
It's another big block, but it's going to stay the same way. All right, Jernigan didn't get much of a rest. They want him back in the game quick. Okay, there's Jernigan for three. It's unbelievable.
I cannot believe it. 56-36, 3:43 left on the clock in the third quarter.
It makes me wish I had watched more of their games this year. And he traveled. He got away with that one. Yep, he did. He moved his pivot. Here comes Orb. A little floater.
Can you get good back
fake.
Up with it?
And it's going to come back this way. Okay, Kawan Miller coming into the game.
56-36, 3:22 left on the clock in the third. Mike, what do you think?
Out of nowhere, it's a 20-point lead. I didn't even notice. Okay, Webb gets through. Captain Kelly. Oh, he walks. Yep. Sometimes you just get too ahead of yourself and you take that extra step. Yeah, I mean, all of a sudden, it's a 20-point lead. There's Kawan for three. No good. Oh, he's in that corner. Where's he going to go? Gets it back to Kawan. Okay, here's Watson penetrating. Good little move there.
Nice move.
Yep. If I'm HMTCA, you're down by 18. Keep attacking the basket. They're quick buckets. Entice them to foul you.
2:37. 56-38.
Okay, Williamson.
Hurricanes
trying to set
with
something
three
up.
Fouls.
Okay, Webb's going to handle it. Crowd's really getting into it right now. Okay, Williamson's going to bring it in. And nope. Okay, Kawan with the rebound. He loses it, though.
Bring it out.
Okay, there's Captain Kelly. He gets hacked. Yep.
Mike, you know what I'm noticing? None of these Hurricanes are seniors. So
really?
They're going to regain all these kids back next year.
That is scary. That's like putting the rest of the league on watch.
Looks like the Hurricanes are going to leave three, lose four.
Jernigan is a 10th grader. He'll be playing for two more years.
And he's still growing.
That's crazy. Oh, look at this move by Orby. Just can't finish. It's almost like he's too fast. Again. You watch him when he drives like that. He tucks that ball underneath as he takes his two steps. Makes it really difficult for the defense to grab it from him. Orb is a ninth grader. A ninth grader for HMTCA. So I must have seen him last year in the middle school game. That's how I know him. But, man, he plays like a senior. He hits the first shot.
56-39. 1:53 left on the clock in the third.
Okay, misses the second shot, and it's coming back this way. All right, McGregor's going to give it to Webb. HMCCA not pressing. They'll meet them at half court, though. All right, let's see the battle of the point guards here. Oh, can't hold it for that long.
Can't hold it. Nope.
If you're going to make mistakes like that, you might as well make mistakes like that when you're up 17 points.
That's right. 56-39, 1:36 left on the clock.
Okay, Williamson backing down. Let's see what Orb does here. Little floater. It was blocked. And that almost a rebound by number 14, Victor Rodriguez. But it's coming back this way. Here's
there
Williamson. Oh, there you go.
Oh, my God. 58-39. Mike, this is not the same team. No. They've lost all their momentum.
I can see the frustration on their faces. They don't know what's going on either, I don't think. There's another big move by Orb. It's fun to watch him dribble. Okay, Hanza can't handle it. It's coming back this way. Okay, here comes Webb. Oh, you better get rid of that ball quick this time. You got to pass. There we go. Williamson has the ball. Al, you think they're slowing it down?
It looks that way.
Yep. It's 47.3 seconds left on the clock. The score is 58-39 in favor of the Hurricanes. You are watching CREC TV. Okay, back in the backcourt. Here comes Webb. Okay, he's going to drive. I think he used an elbow. He did. Yep. See, when you drive like that, when you're dribbling, you can't really stiffen your elbow.
Here we go. 39.8 seconds on the clock in the third quarter. 58-39.
Okay, inbound goes to Orb. He's going to set something up here. Okay, Kawan Miller back to Orb. 32 seconds left on the clock. There's Watson. He's got a screen. He doesn't use it, though. He says, I'm going to the basket. And what a move by Watson.
And he finishes it. 41-58, 21 seconds on the clock.
All right, 20 seconds left. You want to hold for one.
Hurricanes are still up.
All right, dumps off to Captain Kelly.
The Hurricanes, you don't want to turn that ball over right now.
Get your last shot, especially after that last play by Watson. Okay, you got 4 seconds. Williamson's going to bring it in. Oh, what a putback by Webb.
Oh, my God. 60-41 at the end of the third.
I can't contain how excited I am to watch this game. All right, 19-point lead. Wow.
Yeah, this is I'm kind of speechless right now.
You know, Watson had that really amazing play. And if you're HMTCA, you're thinking that's a really good way to go into the fourth quarter on a nice play like that.
Yeah, because you're going into the fourth quarter and you're like that far ahead. I can see Cole Star play the bench right now.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, well, not yet.
Not yet.
Championship game. No, I keep the pedal to the metal. I've seen too many leads just disappear. So, I mean, look what happened to HMTCA.
Yeah.
They were down, what, 6 or 7 points at halftime, and all of a sudden it's 19. Anything can happen.
Well, you know what? I've seen funnier things have been known to happen. This thing can turn around in a heartbeat. The momentum on the Hurricanes bench is changed tremendously.
Yep.
That's one thing you don't want to do. You don't want to lose that edge, that momentum. You got to keep that excitement going.
They can feel it.
They can feel it.
They're 8 minutes away from a championship. Okay, Orb's going to try to make something happen to open up this fourth quarter. You got to be on your game if you're going to come back here.
That's right.
Nice little give and go and a beautiful pass underneath. They just can't handle it. That's a jump ball. I keep saying it, but it is fun watching these teams play.
Oh. It's coming back this way.
Okay, here comes Jernigan. Like, I can't believe he's in 10th grade. I can't believe he's going to be playing for two more years in this league. That's really exciting for this league. Okay, there's McGregor. Oh, what a baseline move. Just can't finish. Okay, Kawan Miller says, I don't want that ball. Give it to Orb. Okay, Kawan Miller. He got him in the air. Penetrates and a nice little floater. Can't connect. Oh, man, you know what it is with HMTCA right now? They're not hitting their shots. They're getting close, but it's just not working out.
Can't put them in the bucket. 7:20 left on the clock, 60-41.
Dumps it off to
Hanzik. Two Rivers Hurricanes.
Oh, there's your Kareem hook again.
There is Kareem.
Yep.
43-60, 7:12 left on the clock.
Here comes Webb. Right at Hanzik. And he gets the rebounds. Again, good defense by Hanzik. Okay, that's Watson right to the hole. Oh, good move getting rid of it before it falls, because that would have been a travel.
Nope.
Here's Jernigan right into traffic. Oh, they're calling that an offensive foul. That's surprising.
It's an unusual call.
Oh, yeah, he jumped into a hornet's nest there. That's either three or four on him.
60-43, 6:51 left on the clock.
Here comes DJ Buckets into the game. Okay, hands out defense. Want to stop everything possible here. Oh, there's a three-point shot. Nope. Hey, Captain Kelly.
Shot right there.
Yeah, I wish I had stats in front of me. I feel like Captain Kelly has at least 20 rebounds by now. Hey, let's see what Jernigan does here. He's got great court vision. He knows what he's doing. He's directing traffic. He's got to get rid of it. There we go. DJ Buckets. He's going to drive right to the hoop, and it looks like he was fouled on the shot. Smart play. Why not?
Smart play. Why not go for it?
Yeah.
60-43, 6:14 left in the game.
Okay, co-captain DJ Sutherland will shoot two. First shot's good. Pretty little spin on that shot.
And Sutherland, just a sophomore.
It's unbelievable. I can't believe what a job putting this team together. You might have a dynasty on your hands.
Definitely.
All right, DJ Buckets hits the second.
62-43, 6:11 left on the clock.
Again, hands up. Oh, look at that defense. Nice little spin by Webb, too. And he's going to take it all by himself. A little too hard off the window.
He's coming back this way.
.601 left in the game. 62-43. Two Rivers. 19-point lead, Al. What do you think?
Oh.
Whew. I don't know, Mike.
Still a little too early to celebrate.
Yep. Oh, yeah, definitely. Okay, good timeout. Good timeout. You got to keep the ball every possession you possibly can. So if you got to waste a timeout there.
That's right.
Your back's completely against the wall right now. Although you're down 19, you want to come out and play with energy. Rattle the other team. I mean, if you get a few buckets in a row, who knows what can happen?
If you're the Phoenix, you really want to start rattling some cages right now. Because
at
this point, what do you got to lose?
Yeah, nothing. Absolutely nothing. And playing hard could kind of spook the other team. I know they're up by 19 points, but you can make something happen here. I've seen stranger things.
Fun stuff.
funnier things have been known to happen.
Yep. Okay, this is, I believe this is the starting five that they used to start the game for the Hurricanes. And this line, well, this starting five has been outstanding. Oh, wide open, Hanzik down low. All right. HMTCA putting the pressure on. All right, they work up the ladder. They're going to slow it down a little bit. Webb's trying to set something up. He's directing traffic too. And he's going right to the hoop. Finishes it all by himself.
Oh, and he finishes it.
Little floater.
64-45.
I thought I saw Derrick Rose for a minute. All right, there's a screen by the big man. Hanzik just can't make it happen.
Back.
Here comes DJ Buckets. He's going to take it by himself, and it is stripped away.
Oh, stripped away.
That was a great hustle by HMTCA.
Oh, threw it away.
And that's what I'm talking about, Al. If they had made that shot, I mean, you're chipping away and you're kind of breaking momentum there. All right, we got a full court press going on. All right, they work it back up the ladder. You cross half court, you're good. Wow.
Ooh.
Crowd reacts to that little shake and bake move. Spud, I almost called him Spud Webb. He's feeling it.
There's Kareem.
There, yep. This is like a throwback game. Spud Webb, Kareem.
64-47 with 4:28 left on the clock. Still led by the Hurricanes.
Okay, Jernigan's going to take it himself, and he misses. A rare miss by Jernigan.
All by
touchdown.
Himself.
Oh, what a block by Webb.
Did you see that?
That's hustle.
What a block.
You know what that is? That's championship hustle right there.
4-4 left on the clock, 64-47.
It's getting loud in here.
It is.
Oh, he hooked him. That's going to be a foul on Kawan. Can't reach around like that. Yeah, Webb knows
what
it.
What a play.
That was a big boy play indeed. That was great. Never give up on a play.
Never.
Okay. There's Sutherland showing off his skills, but I think he stepped out of bounds. Yeah. Well, that's what happens when you have big feet.
Oh, yeah.
3:55 left in the game, 64-47, Hurricanes. You need quick shots here. That's it, just like that. Just keep shooting. It's another rebound for Captain Kelly. So big underneath the rim tonight.
Oh, look at that pass.
Oh, another big block.
Another big block. Oh, my God. Hey,
if you're going to go up, you better go up hard in this game.
You got to go up hard, and they are going up hard.
Okay, McGregor's going to inbound.
3:41 left on the clock, 64-47. Mike, this is
exciting. Sutherland calls for the ball. This is very exciting. And you have a trifecta of captains on the floor right now for the Hurricanes.
Look at that pass.
There's McGregor, in and out. Jump ball. That's another heads-up play by Jernigan.
Look at that. He took on the big man.
Yeah, now twice his size. He just grabs the ball, doesn't let go.
He took on the big man.
Tremendous hustle on both ends for both teams, really.
64-47, 3:28 left on the clock.
Okay, Jernigan getting aggressive down there. Oh, it's coming back. A little too aggressive. That's a heads-up play by the Hurricanes. Okay, here comes Wilfredo Serpa. And he will replace Kervin Vincent for the HMTCA Phoenix. Oh, nice little floater pass. Getting aggressive. Oh, too hard off the window. All right,
still
there's Captain
it,
Kelly.
Well, bring it back, set it up.
All right. Putting on a point guard clinic over here. All right, Sutherland with the ball. 2:53 on the clock. Coaches are saying, get in there, go. And he does. Jernigan, too quick. He's just too fast.
66-47, 2:41 left on the clock.
Another charge. Nope, nope, nope. His feet were moving. Oh, they tried to entice him into a charge again, but I think he took a step right towards the end there. Which I would too. It's like a bull coming at you. Biggest guy in the court, Hanzik, misses the first shot. All right, Captain Kelly will come out of the game. That'll bring in Victor Rodriguez, number 14 for the Hurricanes. And he misses them both.
There you go.
It's McGregor with the rebound. Here comes Webb. Webb and Jernigan just been putting on a show tonight. Here he comes again. Just a little too hard, but there is McGregor. Hey, you know what? These three captains have been outstanding under the rim cleaning up.
That's right. 2:15 left on the clock.
Not enough juice on that pass.
Okay, Mike. I said 3 minutes ago, clear the bench. What do you think now?
I think so. Yeah, why not? Yeah, get those kids in that game. I would.
Let everybody get a taste of this championship.
That's going to be a foul on Rodriguez. Yeah, I mean, you have all these younger players out there. I see a lot of freshmen. Yeah, get them in the game.
Yep, let them taste it. 68-47, 2:06 left on the clock.
Misses the first one. Captain Kelly will come back in the game for Rodriguez. Just got a little rest. Sometimes a coach's mentality is you want the people that got the championship for you to stay on the floor.
Yeah.
It could be that. And another rebound for Captain. He is outstanding. Amazing. I want to see the stat sheet at the end of this game.
1:58 left on the clock. 68-47. The Hurricanes are walking their way into victory.
Takes the shot. No good. There's a rebound by Kawan Miller. Oh, I'm sorry. That is Terrence Weaver Bay.
Nice pass.
Nice little dump off the Orb. Absolutely. Oh, big 3-point shot.
50-68 with 1:33 left on the clock.
Javon Watson with a pretty 3-pointer. Nice little trap there. A minute and a half, it's just not going to be enough. Loses it down low.
This is just what you don't want to happen.
Yeah, big play by Serpa.
52-68, 1:11 left on the clock. You know what? This is how you can screw up.
Yeah. I mean, a minute left. They can screw up all they want here, but it's just not going to be enough. It's a big play there. And another one.
There's another one. 54-68.
And the frustrating thing is, if you're HMTCA, why weren't you playing like this earlier?
There you go.
Oh, they're hacking.
There they go again.
He finishes. And a big putback.
Oh, he didn't get it. Oh, my God, he didn't get it.
Captain Kelly rips down the rebound. Good pass to DJ Buckets. He gets fouled on the shot.
Oh, my God, Mike. 36 seconds left
now,
on the clock.
And I get it. Sometimes the teams have a nothing to lose mentality, but sometimes you have to play that way throughout.
Right.
But you got to be smart about it, not
That's
fouling.
Right.
All right, Captain Sutherland will be at the line for two.
36.1 seconds on the clock. Hurricane 68, Phoenix 54.
You got a feel for the HMTCA bench. Still playing hard.
Still playing hard.
Orb with a nice look to Serpa. He'll finish.
There he goes. 68-56. 26 seconds left on the clock.
Okay, here comes Jernigan. Okay, Sutherland back to Jernigan. It's a screen set by McGregor.
Last 10 seconds left in the game.
Yeah, you're just going to kind of run it out here. You got it.
Just run the clock out.
The ball.
5 seconds left.
And, yep, just going to run it out.
It's a wrap.
What a game.
Mike, we did it again. It's our third year.
Yep.
Great season. I'll see you. I would say I'll see you next year, but
yes,
I'm going to see you tomorrow morning.
Hey, it's been fun, Al.
That's it, man. Thanks.
Final score, 68-56. Two Rivers Hurricanes over the HMTCA Phoenix.
Thanks for watching CREC TV. We'll see you next year.
Have a good night, everybody.